गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, 12th क्लास सीएसटी चैप्टर 5 ऑर्गेनाइजिंग एंड द टॉपिक इज मीनिंग एंड प्रोसेस. Meaning and process of organizing. You all know that management is a continuous process of 5 interrelated functions. Which 5 functions? Planning, organizing, staffing, directing, and controlling. So we can represent like this the process of management, planning, organizing, staffing, directing, and controlling. So you can see that management is a process of 5 interrelated functions. Interrelated functions means the functions which are very much closely related with each other, and one function cannot be performed in isolation. Once we have made the plans, then we will be looking for the organizing function, and all the functions are related in a sequence. Sequence means step by step. We cannot perform the staffing function before performing the organizing. We cannot perform the organizing function before performing the planning. So all the functions are interrelated and joined with each other in a sequence. So planning function we have already done. So today we are going to do organizing. So what is organizing? Organizing means, like, sometimes our room is not in an organized manner. So your mother may say that organize your room. Organize your room means you have to collect all the things whatever in their room, and you have to place them at the required place for which they are to be placed. Similarly, you have to organize your life. Suppose there is a family function in your home, so you have to organize the party. Organizing means, like, if you want to organize a birthday party of yours, so there you need to find out first what will be the budget of the birthday party, to whom you want to call, who will be your guest in your invitation list, where you are going to plan the birthday party, and how you are going to plan the birthday party. It means you are going to decide each and everything. So that will be the planning. Then actually you will be assembling the resources and you will be hosting the party. That will be the organizing. Okay, so organizing means, in planning we have done that what are the resources and what work is to be done. But in organizing actually tells us how the work is to be done. What steps the manager has to take to get the work done from the employees. So organizing is a process which coordinates human efforts, assemble resources, and integrate both into a unified whole to be utilized for achieving specified objectives. You have already studied that in any of the organization, there are 3 types of resources: human resources, physical resources, and financial resources. These are the 3 very much important resources in a business, without which the business is impossible. Financial resources. Physical resources like land, building, machinery, etc. Human resources is the manpower of the organization. We can say staff or the employees of the organization. Financial resources means money. So money is the most important resource, capital we can say, with which the physical resources can be purchased and the human resources can be hired to get the work done. So in organizing, actually, the management is actually collecting the resources and bringing together all the resources to get the work done. to achieve the specified organizational goal. Clear? So organizing is a process which coordinates human efforts. Assemble resources. Which type of resources? Physical resources and financial resources. And integrate both into a unified manner to achieve the organizational specified objectives. So how we can define the organizing? Organizing is a process. Organizing is a process of identifying and grouping the work to be performed. So in the first step of organizing, work is identified and groups are made. Defining and delegating the responsibility. Then authority. Authorities and responsibilities are provided to the human force or the workforce so that they can get the work done. And establishing relationship for the purpose of enabling people to work most effectively together in accomplishing objectives. This definition itself is a process of organizing. This is the complete definition which gives you the idea about the process of the organizing. So whenever in the management you are doing any definition, the definition should be in such a manner that all the steps of the process are very much clear in the definition. Like in the planning process, I have told you the meaning of the planning, and that meaning was containing all the steps of the planning function. So it can be organizing can be defined. We can write one new definition. It is the process of organizing is a process of identifying and grouping. Identifying and grouping. What is to be grouped? Identifying and grouping of the activities. Of the activities and establishing authority and responsibility relationship. Authority and responsibility relationship. Yeah. So basically two things are important in the function of organizing: identifying and grouping of the activities, then establishing authority responsibility relationship. It means authority responsibility relationship means who is superior and who is subordinate, who has to get orders from whom, and who has to give reports to whom. This is known as authority responsibility relationship. Clear? So this complete definition will be giving you an idea for the process of organizing. Now let's go for the process of organizing. So this was the meaning. First step, identification and division of the work. Total four steps are there in the process of organizing. First step, identification and division of work. Second, departmentalization, which is also known as grouping of activities. Third step, assignment of the duties. And the last step is establishing reporting relationship. So these all steps are arranged in a sequence and you cannot disturb the sequence. Clear? So this is the process. Now one by one, I'm going to explain all the four steps. Identification and division of work. Before explaining this step, let's take an example. Have you ever seen, whenever you are going to give a painting work to your home, so you are hiring a painter, or we want to get some carpenter work in our home, then we are hiring a carpenter. So in a carpenter, suppose we want to make a wooden almira in our home. So in that case, only one person you have hired, that is the carpenter, but he will be never coming alone to your home. He will be always coming with his team, maybe two or three persons in his team. Yeah. So all those two, three persons are specialized in doing their work. So one person will never be performing the whole task. They will be dividing the task among themselves according to their specialization area, and the person who is specialized in one area, that person will be performing only that particular task. So this is known as division of work. Clear? Identification and division of work. First step, identification. So identification means, first of all, you have to identify what things are to be done, and division of work. This is the first step. Then you have to divide the work. Divide the work how? Suppose this is the whole task. Now this whole task will be divided in smaller jobs. Okay. Job A, job B, C, D, E, F, and so on. The whole task is divided into smaller units, and each unit is known as a job. Like B is a job, C is a job, B is a job. And each job will be assigned to the person who is specialized, who is expert in performing that job. You can take so many examples of the division of work, like suppose in a school also. We have divided the task. One teacher is teaching you English, one is teaching you maths, one is teaching you economics, and the other teachers are doing their other duties. Non-academic teachers are also there. It means the school, the main objective is to impart the education to the children, to do the overall development of the children, and for this, the whole task of this providing education is divided among different people, and those people are expert in their field. Here, so this is known as division of work. So likewise, in a bank, whenever you visit to a bank, there are different setups are there in a bank, different corners are there, wherever the different expert specialized persons are there. Like one is for the cashier, so you can deposit the cash. Other corner is for the home loan. Other corner is for the personal loan. Some other corner may be there, which is your private banker. Some other corner may be there where you can, reception is there where you can put all the general queries. So in banks also, the whole work is divided into different small segments. So whenever we want to achieve any objective, the first thing is identify that what is to be done, then divide it. Make the small groups and do the division of the work. So in first step, dividing the work as per the plan, which brings specialization. Yes, this is the one important merit of this step. Division of work always brings specialization and avoid duplication. This is the step which may be given in the case study, and this is the line which will be helping you to crack the case study to identify the step of the process. So whenever you are finding this line, it means the step is identification and division of work. The whole work is divided into smaller units, and each unit is known as a job. Second, departmentalization. This step is also known as grouping. Departmentalization is the second step. Departmentalization, and it is also known as grouping. So grouping, you all know very well that after identification and division of work, the next step is to group related and similar jobs under one department. We can take the example from accountancy here. Like in, after making journal, in journal we have passed different entries, then we came to the step of grouping. So grouping there means putting all the similar nature heads under one head. That particular head is known as account. So all the similar nature, suppose there is, we are making a cash account, it means all the transactions which are related to cash will be written under this head, that is a cash account. Clear? So similarly, in business also, departments are created, grouping is done. How the grouping is done? On the basis of similar nature activities. Similar nature activities means one type of activities are grouped under one department, and the other type of activities are grouped under other department. So in schools also, we can find out this grouping. Like after 10th class, you can find out three streams are there: commerce, science, and humanities. It means three groups are there. If I want to make two groups from my class, then I can make those groups on the basis of boys and girls. In boys, all the boys will be there, and in the other group, girls, all the girls will be there. So how I have made the groups on the basis of their gender. So grouping always means bringing together all the similar nature activities at one place. So while making group in the business, how the groups can be made? So the grouping may be done on the basis of functions like production, marketing, all these are the functions, finance, production, marketing, finance, purchase. So all the production related activities will be done in production department. Marketing means selling of the goods related activities will be done in sales department or marketing department. Finance related activities, from where the finance is coming in and to where the finance is going out. All the finance related activities will be grouped together under one department that is known as finance department. Sometimes grouping is done on the basis of products. So this type of grouping is done when you are dealing in a multi-product company. Like, for example, one type of products are grouped together under one division. Like if any company is making automobiles, then in the automobiles, it may manufacture scooters, it may manufacture car, it may manufacture trucks. So there will be separate divisions for all these three automobile transportation media. Scooters, that will be grouped under scooter department. And if one company is completely producing a different line, like one manufacturing company is there, and its one line is manufacturing of clothes, and other line is manufacturing of cosmetics. So for clothes, there will be a separate unit or separate plant, and for manufacturing of cosmetics, there will be a separate unit or separate plant. So this is known as grouping on the basis of product, grouping on the basis of function, grouping on the basis of product, and third is grouping on the basis of territory. Territory. Like a company can make the group on the basis of the territorial reasons, like north, south, west, east, etc. East region, west, north, and south. So definitely when we are making the groups, any of these three bases the organization can follow, then definitely there will be more specialization. Because if we have made the group, then there will be no duplication of the activities. In production department, all the production related activities will be performed. So the employees who are working in the production department will become the expert and specialized in producing the goods. The employees who are working in the marketing department will be expertise in selling of the goods, because from the years they are working in the same department, they are performing the same task again and again, and now they are perfect and expertise in their work. So now come to the third step, which is assignment of the duties. Now it's very much related steps. When we have made the groups, then the third step will be assignment of duties. Assignment of duties. Assignment of duties means this step is performed after grouping various activities into different departments, as we have studied. So it is necessary to define the work of different job positions and to allocate work to various employees. So assignment of duties basically means allocating of the work. Allocating of work. So while allocating the work, it is very much necessary to match the skills and competencies of employees with the job requirement. A proper match between the nature of job and ability of an individual is very important for the effective performance. The work must be assigned to those who are best fitted to perform it. For example, purchase manager, if a person is there and who is having the qualification or degree in purchasing. So purchase, that person must be given the duty of purchase manager, and he must be looking for all the purchase related activities of an organization. For example, there is a person who has done MBA in finance and you have appointed him and you are giving him the work of production manager. So it means his competency, his skills are not matching. So it will be known as mismatch. Mismatch means his competencies, his qualities, his efficiencies are not matching with the job requirement. The person is related to the finance and we have assigned him the job of production department. So he must not be able to perform the job in a better way. So while doing the assignment of duties, the important thing is to match. There must be a match in between the skills and competencies of the employees and the skills and competencies required by a job. There must be a match. For example, if I can teach accountancy and BSc in well manner, but I am allotted English. So I will not be able to give my 100% to teach English. Why? Because my qualification does not allow me to teach English. My experience, my qualification, everything is in these subjects. So I will be better. It will be best for me to give my best in these subjects only. So to get the master effect, to get the benefits of specialization, expertise, it is always necessary to assign the duties by looking for a proper match. If we are not looking for this, then we cannot get the work done effectively. And the last step here is to allocating the work to the different employees based on their skills and knowledge. This one line could be the case study breaking line. So while assigning the duties, we have to must consider. Next, establishing reporting relationship. Establishing reporting relationship means after assigning the duties, the next step is the last step is establishing reporting relationship, which means here the organization has to make it clear that what authority a particular person is having, it means we can say level of authority. And level of responsibility. Whenever we are assigning a job to a person, then always job assignment lead to authority. It means we will be granting him some authority. And granting of authority means that person is responsible to perform that particular duty. So with the assignment of job, authority and responsibility comes automatically. And this we have already studied in the principle of Peon, that there must be a parity in between authority and responsibility. Parity means equality, similarity. Authority and responsibility are the two sides of the same coin and they both go hand in hand. So the person who will be having more of the authority, those persons will be known as the superiors or the bosses. And the persons who will be having lesser authority will be known as the subordinates. So here, establishing authority-responsibility relationship means each and every employee should know that from whom he has to take orders. He has to take orders. And to whom he is supposed to give reports. Clear? Means किससे order लेना है और किसको अपनी performance काम करने के बाद आपको reporting करनी है. Actually, this is known as authority responsibility relationship. And it must be defined. Because if it is not defined, then there will be confusions and the conflicts among the employees and it will be leading to the wastage of time. For example, there is a chain like this. So this chain defines that A is superior and B is subordinate as well as superior. Clear? And C is subordinate. how these suppose working at the middle level and B is supposed to get the orders from A. So we can say A is the superior of B. B is supposed to take the orders from A and he is supposed to give reports to A. Clear? He is supposed to give reports to A. It means A is superior to B and B is subordinate to A. This is known as superior subordinate relationship. And this relationship is very much necessary to establish because until you will not be telling to the employees, there will be confusion in their mind that who is their boss and to whom they are boss. And B is having a relation with A and C both. He has to coordinate with both. B is a superior to C. So it must be clear in the mind of C that he has to take orders from B and he is supposed to give report to B. So it means we can say B is a superior to C and C is a subordinate to B. This is known as superior subordinate relationship. Superior subordinate relationship. So each employee should know from whom he has to take orders and to whom he is accountable. Accountable means to whom he is supposed to give the reports. So this is all about the process of organizing. I'm going back for all the four steps. First step was identification and division of the work, where the work is divided into smaller units. Second step is departmentalization, in which the groups are made on the basis of similar nature activities. Third step, assignment of duties, where the duties are assigned matching to their competency and skills. Fourth, establishing reporting relationship, in which it is made clear that who is subordinate and who is superior, from whom you have to take order and to whom you have to give reports. So this is all about the process of organizing, and each and every manager is supposed to do the organizing process to get the work done. So topic is completed and I hope it is clear.